because of the characteristics of millimeter wave, it has been considered as a solution for the dense small cell networks such as indoor office and shopping malls. However, there is a big challenge in this kind of applications. That is because of the short wavelength at the millimeter wave frequency. For example, at 60 GHz, the wavelength is only 5 millimeters. As we all know, the human body dimension is 20 to 30 times of the wavelength. That means, compared to lower frequency, it's very difficult for the wave to penetrate through the body or diffract around the human body. In order to fully investigate the human body effect on millimeter wave wireless channels, I've conducted a series of millimeter wave measurements by using the transmitter as a smartphone we use in our daily life and the receiver as a wireless access point. During the measurement, different daily user behaviors have been considered. For example, like user holding a smartphone and holding a template. Afterwards, re-recorded data will be analyzed using some softwares like MATLAB. I'm not only interested in the raw data, but also the hidden information behind the raw data. For example, how many dBs can human body affect the millimeter wave wireless channel? Is 10 dB, 20 dB, or even more? More importantly, why is this happening? You can have different ways to interpret this phenomenon. For example, using static tools or theories, or explain it from the basic physics, like electromagnetic theory. You can dig in deep with different methodologies you are interested in. So understanding the human body effect on millimeter wave wireless channels, you can use this to tackle the problems, for example, characteristics of propagation for future 5G networks. I'm from Fujian province of China, and I choose Queen's University Belfast because its reputation is within top 1% of the world, and the working and studying environment here is wonderful. Here you see the advanced equipment we have in our lab, and the project I'm working on is highly fascinating and motivating. Finally, there's a very inclusive culture in our center. Here you see our staff and students are from China, Korea, UK, France, Italy. All of them collaborate together to produce the highest quality research. I find that exciting.